Oh, hey, didn't see you there. I haven't seen you since like last year. Well, in today's video, we're gonna go over 22 problems that you might encounter as you embark on your After Effects journey. That's a lot of problems and we got a lot of solutions. So let's get started. Cheers.
Okay, have you ever animated something and you could swear that these two keyframes are the same, but yet it's still moving between them? Well, that's because your spatial interpolation is set to Bezier instead of linear. So to fix that, we'll just grab these two keyframes that are the same and we'll go to keyframe interpolation and we'll see that the spatial interpolation is set to continuous Bezier. If I set that to linear and hit OK, now it does not move in between those two keyframes. Have you ever created a shape and when you created it, you realized that the anchor point is off to the side like this? Kind of annoying, right? Well, one thing you can do is hit Control Alt Home to center your anchor point in the center of your shape. You can also go up to your preferences and make sure that this little checkbox is turned on, which will always center the anchor point in your new shape layers. And what about if you wanted to move your anchor point down to the bottom here? Well, you could come over to the anchor point and you could adjust it so that it's at the bottom, but then you move your layer and then you'd have to reposition your layer. What if you wanted to skip that and just move this to the bottom? Well, that's where the pan behind tool comes in handy. With the pan behind tool, I can move the anchor point without moving the position of my layer. Now, I considered not including this next one just because it does require a third-party tool, but I thought, what the heck, why not? It's super useful. So what about those times where you've already animated your shape layer or whatever, and you realize that the anchor point is off to the side? And you might think like, well, what the heck, it still looks good, it's fine. But then when you go to add some like stretch and squeeze, for example, and so you start playing with the scale and you want to scale it, it starts to wig out because it's scaling from the anchor point. Well, there's this handy little tool from Animation Composer called the Anchor Point Mover. And this tool has two modes. You can insert a keyframe to playhead or you can modify existing keyframes. So if I want to move this anchor point to this bottom here, I just have to make sure that I'm set to modify existing keyframes. Then I hit the down arrow and boom. Now my ball is in the exact same spot, but now my anchor point is in the right spot. So now I can go in and add my stretch and squeeze. Now, this video is not sponsored by Mr. Horse and their Animation Composer 3, but the Anchor Point Tool Mover comes as a free add-on when you install this plugin. And you can actually install this plugin for free. You don't have to buy any of their presets. So if you just want the Anchor Point Mover, you can come here to MrHorse.com and download the Animation Composer 3 to install that. Okay, so we've talked a lot about moving the anchor point, but what if I want to actually move this entire animation over so that the ball starts off screen? You might think we'll just take the first keyframe and move the ball off screen, but then it changes the motion and it doesn't look right. I want to move all the keyframes over. Well, to do this, I'll just select all the keyframes that I want to move, and then I'll make sure that my playhead is on one of the keyframes. And just to demonstrate this, I'll just make sure that it's on my second keyframe here. And I made sure it's on the keyframe by holding shift, which will snap it to the keyframe. And then with all my keyframes still selected, I can actually move the entire motion path until this first keyframe is off the screen. Now, I can check it, make sure, nope, the ball is not quite off the screen, so I can continue to move that. And now when I play it back, it comes from off screen. Now, have you ever placed some Illustrator files in your composition and you realize that they're blurry and you're scratching your head because they're vector files, they're not supposed to be blurry? Well, there's two ways to fix this. One way is to continuously rasterize by turning on these little switches, and as you can see, it's automatically sharpened up. The other way is to actually convert these Illustrator layers to shape layers. When you do that, it actually turns it into an editable shape layer that you can edit inside of After Effects, and it will sharpen it right up. So here's a scenario. Let's say you've just created your title and you're pumped about it, but then you take a step back and you realize, shoot, I didn't actually create that in the middle of my composition and I need it to be in the middle. Well, here's a little trick for repositioning multiple layers that already have position keyframes on them. Go up to layer, new, and create a null object, and then you can parent those layers to that null object, and then you can use that null object to reposition your title into the middle, and then you can delete that null object if you don't need it anymore, and voila, your title is now in the center of your composition. Have you ever been in the middle of a tutorial and they're like, okay, now just go and turn your track mat to alpha mat. And you're like, wait, what? I don't see this option. Where is it? Well, it's pretty simple. It's just, you're probably looking at this, right? To get to your track mats, you just have to toggle to them right here. And if you don't want to have to remember to toggle between these two, you can actually just turn everything on with this little button down here. So now I have access to my switches and my track mat all in one place. Okay, for an animation like this, I also wanna use the shape behind the text layer as a way to reveal the text layer so that I don't see the text all jumbled up over here. So normally I could just select my shape layer and duplicate it, place it above my text layer and change the track mat on my text layer to alpha mat. Now when I play that back, my text layer is revealed by the shape layer behind it. But here's the problem with this approach. If I want to, if any changes I make, say to the timing or the shape of my shape layer behind it, will not be reflected in the shape layer that I duplicated. So then I'd have to go back and make all those changes to that layer as well. And in an example like this, where I'm only dealing with one shape layer, not that big of a deal, but in certain situations where you're dealing with lots of track mats, this can be pretty time consuming. So in order to streamline this process, instead of just duplicating my shape layer, I'll just select my shape layer and I'll come up to edit and copy with property links, and then I'll hit Control V to paste it. And now I have a shape layer that is linked to my original shape layer, so that any changes I make to this shape layer will be reflected in the top shape layer. So as you can see, if I make adjustments to the timing, it will be reflected in the top layer. Now again, I can set this track mat to alpha mat, and now all I have to worry about is making changes to this original shape layer, and all those changes will be reflected in the duplicated shape layer. Have you ever come up to the layer to make a new layer and it's grayed out and you're wondering what the heck's going on? Why can't you make a new layer? Well, that's because you don't have your timeline panel active. You'll know that it's active when it has this little blue line around it. You might be on your project panel. In that case, you cannot make a new layer. You have to have your timeline active in order to make a new layer. Now, what about effect? Have you ever come to apply an effect to something and all the effects are grayed out? Well, that's because in order to apply effect, you have to tell After Effects what layer you want to apply it to. So you have to have at least one layer selected before you can apply an effect to it. If you don't have any layers selected, your effects will be grayed out. So what about footage or images that are way bigger than your composition? Well, an easy way to snap them to the size of your composition is just to come to Transform and Fit to Comp. That will snap them right to your composition, and now it is the right size. But what about images that don't conform to the 16:9 aspect ratio? If we use Fit to Comp, then we're getting something weird here. Well, in this case, we'd actually use Fit to Comp Width. which will maintain the original aspect ratio of the image, but it will scale that image down to fit within inside your composition. Have you ever just been working on something and all of a sudden your composition disappears and you just see a layer or a solid here? That's because you've accidentally double clicked on that layer, which has opened it up in the layer panel. To get back to your composition, just click back on your composition here on this tab. Okay, do you ever have a composition that plays back really slowly and you're constantly making changes and constantly waiting for it to render the RAM preview? Well, there's a couple things you can do to speed up the playback. One thing is to go to your preview tab here and tell it to skip frames as it does the render preview. This is good for just kind of gauging timing and flow of your animation. Another thing you can do is obviously turn down the resolution of your RAM preview, which will speed it up a little bit. Another thing you can do is go in and you can select certain layers and turn them to draft. That will help speed things up a little bit. Have you ever gone to edit your shape layer and you don't see any of the points or the path? That is because you have this little button right here toggled off. You toggle that back on, now you can see your points. Have you ever had a situation where you can see the path and you can see the points, but when you go to click on a point, you can't see the handles and it seems to be clamped between these two positions? That's because your path is set to roto bezier. And to reset it, just right click on one of the points, go to mask and shape path, and turn off roto bezier. Now you have full control over your points. Have you ever gone to draw your shape and when you do, you draw a mask instead and you're like, what the, I don't want to draw a mask. Well, that's because you have a layer selected. So if you want to draw a shape and not a mask, just make sure to unselect your layer first. And then when you draw your shape, it'll create a new shape layer instead of a mask. And vice versa, if you go to draw a mask and instead you create a new shape layer, you just have to make sure that your layer is selected and then you can draw a mask. Okay, I don't know about you guys, but I love to animate in 12 frames per second. But have you ever had a situation where you have your animation all set up, it's looking good, and you go to embed it into another composition and that composition is set at a different frame rate? And then your original composition is playing at that new frame rate and it just doesn't look like it did when you originally animated it. That is because whenever you have a frame rate that you want to maintain, you have to go up to your composition settings, and in the advanced tab, you have to check this little box here that preserve frame rate when nested or in render queue, or in this case, recompose. So since this composition is nested in this composition, now when I play this back, my composition will play back at 12 frames per second, even though the composition it's nested in is set to 23.976. Okay, this next one is a rare one, but you might have experienced it. And that's when whatever is in your composition seems to get stuck there. You go to a different tab, and no matter what, it just seems to be stuck in the background. Well, if that ever happens, just go up to Edit and purge all your memory and disk cache, and then restart After Effects. That should help fix this problem. What about when you want to export something for Instagram, for example, and you go to export in the render queue and there's no H.264 option? Even if I go into QuickTime and I go to the video codec, we have ProRes, but those files are going to be way too big. So I need a compressed format. Well, in this case, instead of using the render queue, we just queue it up in our media encoder. And in here, we can use all the same video formats that we use in Premiere. And we have H.264 available to us. Okay, a super common question that I got on my smoke animation tutorial is, how did I grab these corners of my rectangle and move them? Well, the answer is that I drew out my rectangle with the pen tool and not the rectangle tool. The pen tool will create a bezier shape that you can then deform using the convert vertex tool. But when you create a shape with the rectangle tool, you're creating a parametric shape that cannot be changed using the convert vertex tool. This is something that I went over in my video about shape layers. If you're wanting to know more about that and you want to learn more in depth, go watch that video. However, when you make a parametric shape and you want to be able to deform it, you can convert it to a bezier path by right clicking here on the rectangle path and clicking convert to bezier path. Now, when I have my convert vertex tool, I can grab these corners and move them around. Okay, what about this situation where you're working on a project and you've got all these different pre-comps open and you go and you double click into one and you do your thing and then you need to get back to the original composition that you had just open, but you have so many of these tabs open, you can't remember which one of these guys is the one that you need to go back to. Well, there's a simple way to navigate through your project file, and that is with the flowchart. The flowchart will tell you on the left which composition your current open composition is embedded in and any compositions that are embedded in the current composition. So if I need to go back to wherever I started, I can just go back to this composition and now I'm back to where I was. Okay, have you ever had a situation where you accidentally hit a key and all of a sudden all you can see is your timeline and you're like, where did my composition window go? Where did my project panel go? Where did my side panels go? Well, that's because you've hit the tilde key, which has made the current panel that you were in full screen. So just hit that tilde key and now you're back to normal. And if you ever wanted to go full screen with the composition window, you could do that and then you could hit that. And then boom, you've got a full screen.
Well, if you made it this far, thanks for watching. And if you found that this video was helpful, please consider hitting that like button. It really does help me in the YouTube algorithms. And if you want more content like this in the future, consider subscribing. And now I'm gonna have to do what everybody does, where I show you that only 12% of you guys are subscribed, and plot twist, that's okay. That's okay, 87% of you guys are not subscribed, you're new to my channel, and that's okay. You don't have to subscribe. I'd appreciate it if you subscribed and you hit that bell icon, but if you're not comfortable subscribing yet, that's okay, no pressure. Just do you, okay? Thanks for watching. We're gonna have a lot of new videos coming out this year. We've got some exciting stuff coming up, so if you wanna be in the know, make sure you're subscribed because I will be announcing that all here on my YouTube channel. So, until the next video, we'll see you guys later.